W. My name is Lynn Pearson. I'm a member of 1LC Speakeasy, New Faith Toastmasters, and University Park Speaks Up. Our speaker today is Stephanie Kurokawa. Today's presentation is designed to get you to think outside the box. By keeping an open mind, you will experience a hands-on, interactive workshop. Just like in Toastmasters, when we are aware of what we are doing, we have the ability to change. Learn how to change your BMW so you can take 100% responsibility for your life. Have you ever wanted more from life? Do you feel stuck and need a new direction? Are you looking for some new challenge in your life? If you answered yes, our speaker today will change you, will challenge you to change the way you think. Our speaker today has walked on fire, ran a successful advertising business for over 20 years. She's a professional manager. She manages the day-to-day activities of her daughter, of her household, and manages somehow with all of that to work out every day. Our speaker, trainer, creative inspirer, please join me in welcoming Stephanie Kurokawa.
Lucy's going to help. help me demonstrate this. Do you have any problems with your arms, your shoulders, anything like that? Okay, and which is your dominant arm? So I'm going to work with Lucy on her left side. Put your arm out right here. Now, I'm going to test Lucy to see how strong she is, okay? So I want you to resist my pushing that, okay? You can see she's really very strong. Okay, now I want you to tell me what your name is.
Lucy.
Okay, and we're going to put your arm out again. So that's her strength. She's telling the truth. Now, I want you to come up with some fictitious names.
Fictitious names?
Yes. Come up, just call yourself something else.
Cookie.
Good. Put your arm out. And your name is?
Cookie.
See how it comes down? Okay. So that's one of the things that we're working on. When we're telling ourselves the truth and we're telling ourselves all positive things, we're that much stronger. There's that much energy in our bodies. But when we're BMWing, that's what drains our energy. It's not just the energy that we have, it has a lot to do with our physical bodies also. It takes a drain on our physical bodies. So tell us, Lucy, I'm out again. Say, I'm a good girl.
I'm a good girl.
Okay? So what do you think? It's gonna be strong, right? Energies to them. focus on. So at any point in time in your life, instead of a BMW, you can change your focus. Once again, this will bring a lot more energy to you, not just yourself, but also your body. So once again, if you want to increase that energy, focus on the positive. Think of these things that I just gave you. Your self-talk. Those are things that are really important as you move forward. As I was going through my life, and I made some changes, some very personal changes, probably within the last 5 years, and working on this positive, but it's not just positive mental attitude, it's really embodying all of that. Recently, I came across this formula. And when I heard it, I thought, oh my God, this is incredible. How simple is this? E plus R equals O. Your events plus your response will equal your outcome. So many people blame the events. The events cannot be changed. It's your response to the events that will create your outcome. Now let's talk about an event. What if you got into an accident, right? That's an event. Your response to that accident, could it be that you're really mad, it was the other person's fault? But in reality, how much did you contribute to that accident? Changing your response to it will either bring it as a positive outcome or a negative outcome. And there's always, I tell my kids, there's always a lesson to be learned in every experience that you have in life. How many of you remember this movie? What was the event in this movie? It was the tournament. How is he going to beat this opponent in the tournament? They were doing all kinds of nasty things to him, right? But he was always keeping a very positive frame of mind in regards to how he's going to go about this. And in the end, he won. A similar story. I used to take karate class. And in my class, there was this guy. He was a younger guy. He was probably in his late 20s to early 30s. And he was all testosterone driven and just, you know, he would beat everybody up, from the kids to everybody. He didn't really care who it was. Well, it was time for testing. And as we test, you have to spar with every single person in the room. Guess what? It was my turn to go up against him. And I thought, you have got to be kidding me. There is no way that I was ever going to win against him. And so my sensei, as he saw me, I was very dejected. He said, come here. So I kind of walked over like this. And I said, yeah. He said, okay, I'm going to change your frame of mind right now. And what he told me was, this opponent, this guy that you're up against, he has your kids. In order for you to get your kids, you will have to go through him. Do you think that changed my response? The event was still the same. I still had to spar against this guy. But it was a whole other frame of mind. So I went up there, and that's the only thing I envisioned. My kids were being held by this guy. And think he was going to get away with it? Oh no. So I went up to this guy, and within seconds, I just nailed him! And everybody in the gym was like, oh my God, because the guys and the kids were so big, couldn't stand this guy. And I scored on him right away, and I got the points. And after I did that, I realized how important, how we focus, and what we focus on is really important. So I want you to think about this. E plus R equals O. When you get it, it is amazing how much it changes your life. Now let's go over have to versus choose to. How many of you believe that you have to do something? You have to. Okay, you have to pay your taxes?
Yes.
Have to go to work?
Go jam.
What else? You have to stop at that stoplight?
No.
Yes. What else? Tell me. What else do you believe you have to do? You have to eat? Okay. You have to die? All right. Anybody else?
You have to breathe.
You have to breathe?
Yeah.
You have to sleep?
Well, you have to sleep?
Ah, sleep is optional.
Or debatable.
No. Your body shut down sooner or later.
Do you really have to pay your taxes?
No.
There are many people out there that don't pay their taxes.
Where are they?
They're in jail. Well, that's the choice that they make. Have to? Choose to. So are you having to do something or are you choosing to do something? You choose to do something because of the repercussions, the outcome that will happen if you don't do something, correct?
Mm-hmm.
You stop at that stop sign. Do you have to? No, you don't. Guess what? You'll land in jail. If you don't, or you can cause a major accident. Once again, it's your choice. And your name is?
Donna.
Now, Donna, what would happen if she was standing here and I came up to her and I had a gun in my hand? And she had a gun pointed to her child. And I said, if you don't shoot your child, I will shoot you. What would you do?
Shoot me. Because I've been here longer.
That's the choice she makes. She doesn't have to, but she chooses to do that. Does that make sense? Now what if I said, thank you, I said, Stan, out of everybody in this room, you have got to be the biggest jerk that I have ever met. Now with me saying that to Stan, what do you think? Do you think that would alter his perception of who he is? Do you think that would put him in a positive or a negative frame of mind?
It depends.
You just failed the E plus R equals O. Because in reality, what I say to Stan has nothing to do with him. It's what he says to himself after I walked away from that. I'll give you a heart attack. Okay, have to versus choose to. Now remember I'm talking about 5% or 100% responsibility. I'm going to have Lynn, did you give out the?
Not yet.
Okay, to hand out a worksheet. And I know 100% responsibility is really intimidating for most people, right? But what if we started with 5%. Just 5%. Just take that little baby step. Okay? I'm passing this out and we're going to go over a few of these questions. So what would you do if you just took 5% more responsibility of your life? This is the handout that we're going to go over. And I'm going to give you some time. Work with your partner. I'll give you about 10 minutes to go over this. And I will give you, we'll go over the first one together.
For those that don't have it, please refer to the questions that are up here.
Yes, yes. Sorry. I will go over that. So the first one is, if you were to take 5% more responsible for your life and well-being, what would it be? I would exercise 30 minutes more a day. I would only eat fast food one time per week. Well, that would be. I would meditate more often, and I would get more sleep. So that's for the first one. If I were to take 5% more responsibility for my life and well-being, I would exercise 30 minutes a day. I would only eat fast food one time per week. I would meditate more often, and I would get more sleep. How many of you don't have handouts? Oh. Okay, I'll give you the next four questions, or not questions, but statements. If I were to take 5% more responsibility for living my passion, I would...
Give us examples, that was helpful.
No, these are examples that you're going to do with your partner. If I were to take 5% more responsibility for living my passion, I would... The next one, if I were to take 5% more responsibility for the attainment of my goals, I would, once again, if I were to take 5% more responsibility for the attainment of my goals, I would, next, if I were to take 5% more responsibility for the success of my relationships, I would, what would that be? If I were to take 5% more responsibility for the success of my relationships, I would, another one, if I were to take 5% more responsibility for the level of my self-esteem, I would, what would that be? If I were to take 5%, just 5% more responsibility for the level of my self-esteem, I would. And I will give you 10 minutes to work on this. Ready, begin.
I love you, Stan.
Yeah.
What about you?
No, I'm still good.
go to comedy clubs? Would you not take life so seriously? Would you dance more?
Yes.
Would you play more music?
All of us.
Well, I'm going to give you a chance to do a couple of them. And get off! Oh well, sorry. But you guys are up. So, how's your energy now? Do you feel more positive versus your BMW?
Yes.
Okay, so you're not like this kid in the middle where he's blowing steam off like that cartoon where he's like, I've had it. Are you more like this little girl that's smiling? Mine is this one. Yes! Right! So, I always like to leave people with a challenge at the end. The paperwork that you filled out with the questions within the next 30 days, I want you to pick one and implement it. Action starts now. What I have found whenever I'm in some kind of seminar or something, the best way to start is to take action at that event. So what will that 30 days look like? Pick one. I've given you all an evaluation form. You can email me what it is so I know what you're working on. Anybody have any questions?
You may need to tell them your email address. Everyone has it.
My email address is Stephanie. Not everyone has the sheet. Stephanie at StephanieKurokawa.com. And I'll, my last name is KuroKawa. Guys, have fun?
Thank you guys.